Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for taking time from your busy schedules to be with Debbie and I tonight. We are honored by your presence, and I want to let you know before we get started here, and I promise to be brief, because I've stood out there entirely too many nights and somebody I didn't know talked too long. One night my attention span stopped before their speech did. Well, ladies and gentlemen, tonight is all about two groups of people. Actually, three, because I'm going to talk about them and the kids in a minute. But the first group of people is everybody on the west side of the parade deck. And it's all about you. And you represent many, many more who could not come tonight, but we hope to come. Probably because they had a tale I needed to hear again, or because I owe them a beer too. But you're all here so we can say thanks to you. Because it does take a team, it takes a village. And I want to, Debbie and I want to thank all of you for being friends, for being family, for being supporters, for always being there. For not only for us, but more importantly for Marines and sailors and soldiers and airmen. So the first group is all about you. The second group, if you'll allow me to turn my back, is all about them. And it's all about the Marine Corps. There's about 222 of them out here on the parade deck. The 6x6 in the DMV there, the guys, my major. So it's all about them. And they represent 183,524, depending on how many we did listen to discharge, that are all around the world doing the Lord's work, along with our battle buddies, soldiers, sailors, and the Marines, all together. So it's all about these two groups that I want to try and connect them. And I'm trying to do it correctly. So Margaret, Jacqueline, thanks for being here, thanks for the kind words. You spared me and them the agony of a moment in history, for a moment in history. So I will tell you, I can't call this one we need to know. Thank you. Mr. Secretary, thanks for being here, sir. You're incredibly busy, you're all over the world. You didn't need to be here tonight. Now I could shoot you in Syria or Turkey, but you could be out in Northwest on vacation. And I know you and Steph adjusted some pretty healthy schedules yesterday, today, and tomorrow to be here. So you honored Debbie and I. Secretary was most gracious in his words. I mean, he was actually the brains of the counter-agency task force. I was just a point man breaking down a couple of doors. He came up with lines like, we're going to upwire before we rewire. But I'm going to help a lot working with you, working for you, sir. So it's a great team. We're honored to have you back to the fourth time overall, but the third time in 8 years in government. Thanks for your leadership. Steph, thanks for being a friend. I appreciate it. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to talk long. There are some folks I would be remiss if I didn't bring to your attention just because they're here, and also because they represent a lot of other folks. So in addition to the DEF SecDef is here, Secretary Work, formerly Colonel Bob Work, artillery minister of the PPO together in the state, and my boss and my battle buddy is the Undersecretary of Navy. Thanks for being here, and thanks for all you do, sir. Countless other under Japanese assistants, both in the Defense Department and the Department of the Navy. And I'm going to do what the Aussies and the South Africans do, all honors and broad goals and serve. That's as good as it gets. Okay? And I love you all, okay, but we're sparing the Marines, okay? In addition, we have soldiers, sailors, and airmen here. And I'm just going to pick one or two from each of them. On the soldier side, our leader and my boss from Iraq, General David H. Petraeus, is here. You talk about somebody you had. Spirit and character and courage and will and could not be denied. You think about what was going on in Iraq in 07 and 08, both before and after the surge, and what General David Petraeus did, and what people tell you freely all those soldiers, sailors, and airmen did. But you need a leader up there. You need somebody who's thinking for you, breaking down some doors, can put the message in three or four bullets and get it out there. General Petraeus was exactly that for all of us. And I know there's about an 8-hour testimony you and Ambassador Crocker did one day that you'd rather not go down, and you wish you could get those 8 hours back, sir. But that kind of set the message for everybody for all of you did. So, CG, thanks. Great to have you with us. On the Army side, too, I want to thank my battle buddy, the much larger, handsomer, better-looking man, Lloyd Austin, and also my battle buddy from the J3 now, Chief of Staff, the Army, Mark Miller. So, from all your Marine battle buddies and mates to our soldiers, and you can see my dad's picture in there, proud soldier in the Second World War, thanks for being with us. All our sailors, my shipmates here, but those are Pitman, Big Al Myers, Al Hitman, Al is here, Vice CNO, Admiral Moran is here, Admiral McGinn, a lot of others. Thanks all to the Navy shipmates who've been here. And the fingers cold being is Aaron McDew. You're here from Transcom, he's from the Air Force. Thanks for being here. And that'll buy you a beer afterwards, okay? So ladies and gentlemen, that's kind of the military history here. I could go on, but proud of all of them. I have a lot of bosses and mates here from the Marine Corps. My first two battalion commanders are here, Lieutenant Colonel Lee Gonzalez and Colonel John Capka. And you got to get started in the right direction. And they got me started in the right direction. And believe me, I was listening louder a few times. So thank both of them and all others. And if you really want to go way back, General Pete Osmond is here, who was my staff two commander in basic school. And he will tell you that this is truly a lot of money got lost on this bet here. I'm a professional performer who just hung on long enough. I'm going to spin my groups here, too. I got three or four buddies from high school up here who played football, basketball, baseball with them. You're up here to represent all this West, the Phillies and the Eagles. I got a lot of mates from college here, fraternity, football, baseball, football, lacrosse. I'm proud of all of them. Thanks for being with us. I want to point out one in particular, and I know he's going to get mad at me, and I won't make him stand up and coach for me. Coach Richie Moran is here.
Stand up, Richie.
Richie Moran.
Stand up.
Years leading the Big Red up at Ithaca. Three national championship teams, three backup teams, 12, I think, Ivy champions, and a couple of All-Americans. I was none of that, but I was pretty proud to be on the team. And I left as well as my movement old friends could be a little lower. You can't pick up the ground ball. He was pretty crazy. He's like a Marine Corps. I could go on. Please, don't let me talk a little bit just about the Marines. As represented by the 222 behind us. And General Mallory was kind enough to say, I have the honor and privilege of serving in all three of our active divisions, four of the five major bases. I'm real proud that I'm pretty mobile. But it's all about the team. It's all about the team. There's many here that I can't recognize, but I see you, there's a reason you're on the list. I got mates like George Solly that I was lieutenants with in 1-3. I got folks like Steve Gavis, who were Deputy Director of CIA, who I was with in 2-4. I got a buffalo and company commanders from here at the barracks, like Jim Lasker and Jeff Barrett. I got battalion commander mates. They all mean something to me. Down here at the end, there's about 40 of them who came up from Quantico in a symposium, and there's a host more scattered around. But those are all the sergeants, major, master gunneries, and master sergeants and command master chiefs. So at least every time they got me into trouble, always got me out. But I think the world of them. And our staff non-commissioned officer corps is the backbone of our corps. And I treasure their friendships and their leadership. For Sergeant Gary Trescott, for Sergeant Frank Coley, you're still killing me. My family is here. My brother Bob, sister Mary, their in-laws, their loved ones and children, our three children, John, Avery, and Carolyn, who are probably our greatest accomplishments. W. Lesby, claim partial credit for that. But real proud of all three of them and the adults they have become. Heavy citation, rightfully, longer, better, stronger, more richly deserved. Because thanks. It's been 36 years. I've treasured every minute of it. Sorry I broke into the Air Force connection. But like Commandant alluded to, we married all our stations. So thanks for staying with us, Deb, and I know they're glad you're sticking around. There's a couple of them are glad I'm the only one with two, but everybody's glad you're sticking around with me. So thanks, I love you. So ladies and gentlemen, real quick, if you take anything from all this, three things. It's about the team, and it's about the ride. So I'm honored to be on the team. I call everyone to do Big Marine. Marine Corps lied to me, I thought it was only 3 years, every time they tricked me, I guess they knew better than I did that it was actually worth it. The way you were going to actually work out. The reason I ended in PMR was General Jim Jones, Commandant, who was here. He called up and gave six of us notification to identify the brigadier general.
I had met General Jones here with the barracks years ago. He was a marching and company commander here. And he called up and gave the flash of line. He said, "Hey, Dennis, this is General Jim Jones." I said, "Yes, sir. It's the command center they called. I know who it is. I'm standing in attention." And it was Friday before St. Patrick's Day weekend in New York. So I'm trying to figure out why I'm going to the Commandant and I can't be on Fifth Avenue with some Irish pub. You know, when I was like, "I got good news and I got bad news." So I said, "Sir, I need the bad news first." He said, "You know, it doesn't work like that." So the good news was you get selected for Brigadier General. Now I am really nervous, okay?
Yeah.
And the bad news was I went off the programs and resources, the PNR, and that kind of stink. So, but General Jones knew what he was doing. I think he had more faith in me than the rest of the institution did. But that's emblematic of what we're all about. So I'm really glad to see you up there as well, too. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is about the team. I'm proud to play on the team. So, number one, it's all about the team. Number two, as Commandant said, you grow well and you live. It is like that line from Judah Ben-Hur in the movie that says, "We are all condemned men. We live for the good of the ship. Grow well and live." And that was our motto down in the Joint Staff. I see the way Austin Lamb and over there, Mark Billy. But that's what you do. You grow well and you live. And my final slide, ladies and gentlemen, is about why you do this. And it's because of a career in any of the services, Army, Navy, Infantry Corps, particularly the Marine Corps tonight, coming back to this great place is how I'm grounded in the barracks. It's like a patrol. And you never know when you start out with it. It may be a recon patrol, but you know damn well if I run into a combat patrol. And you're not sure when or where, so you have to prepare for it. You think it's a patrol, you know it's a recon patrol, and you know it's going to be a long patrol. And you just have to get ready to welcome the patrol. And you really are a connecting file. If you're in harm's way, you're a connecting file from the flank, from the point, from the rear. It's been my honor and privilege to be on the team, to be a connecting file between better folks who are walking point, sharper shots who are on the flanks, better gunners who are behind. I was just proud to be on the team, and I'm still proud to be on the team. And tonight, Debbie and I are in the rear of friendly lines. And when you re-enter friendly lines, it's usually pretty hazardous. Yeah, sometimes I haven't said that. Okay? You know, somebody forgets to jot down the password, somebody gets spooked. It's not a good thing. You feel a whole lot better when you're inside friendly lines. Well, we're all here that were in high school and college, you represent friendly lines. So don't shoot, no messenger. Right? I'm coming, don't shoot. And for everybody here, thanks for walking patrol with me. It's been an honor and privilege to serve. We value your friendship. I'm grateful for your leadership. Debbie and I are mindful for all the good things you have shown us and done for us. And as the Secretary and others did, we got a lot of extra credit for stuff we didn't do. The things that we were really proud of, pick up the stick, pick up the rifle, and just be on the team and on patrol with you. So when you do any last round of applause, it's for the team, it's for these 222 on the deck, and 183,600 around the world. Thank you all. God bless you all. Semper Fidelis.